As the countdown for the February general elections begins, it is disturbing that political violence has continued to spread unabated, even after the presidential flag bearers of the various parties signed a peace pact. The essence of the peace pact is to enhance peaceful electioneering before, during, and after the general elections. Scheduled to begin with the presidential election of February 14, 2015. Regrettably, the understanding by political leaders to avoid actions that would promote violence before, during, and after the polls is being ended or eroded by the very violence the accord seeks to prevent. We had political violence incidences 2 months ago when some supporters of the APC in Rivers State were shot on their way to attend their party's presidential campaign flag-off, and till date no arrests have been made over the incident. Shortly after the political violence continued to escalate across the country, the campaign buses of President Goodluck Jonathan were set ablaze in Jos, the Plateau State capital, while several properties said to belong to the PDP in Gombe State were razed down. The latest of the political violence was reported at the hometown of the Nigeria's First Lady, Mrs. Patience Jonathan, where the suspected political thugs attached to members of the APC who were setting up equipment and canopies for a scheduled political rally. If before election proper, violence is escalating, such has been recorded, what will happen during and after elections when the result must have been declared? In the past 1 week, the signs are becoming ominous that violence may just resurge again after the peace pact. Only last Tuesday, President Goodluck Jonathan, who was on a campaign tour of Katsina State, was ambushed by youth in the palace of the Emir of Katsina, where his vehicles were pelted. From Gombe, Rivers, Kaduna, Lagos to Abia State, it is one bloody story of bloodied characters. And in the whole of the bloody mix, the nation's security agencies, particularly the Nigerian Police Force, have a very great role to play. There's been an escalation of violence, a situation that has reached an alarming state, even as it is daily assuming a frightening dimension, with the participations and political parties pretending to know anything whatsoever about the violence. The parties, especially the APC and the PDP, keep putting blames on each other and both holding the other responsible. APC supporters reportedly attacked the state office of the PDP in Sokoto State. An explosion was reported at the Secretariat of the Progressive People's Alliance, PPA, in Abia State. The PPA chairman blames the PDP for this. Campaign posters and billboards are being defaced, targeted, or flushed by respective parties, which is an act undermining each other's campaign. Both Jonathan and Buhari have on some occasions declared that election is not warfare. Yet their parties are the major cause of political violence, it seems. Now the question is, what is the way out of these violent acts?